Yeah, well, I mean, that's absolutely true. I mean, that acting prime minister, he is on the terrorist list of the United States. I mean, he's on the United Nations blacklist. And also the interior minister, Sarojuddin Haqqani, who's the head of the Haqqani network, a very, very deadly network, which has been responsible for carrying out some of the very horrific operations in Afghanistan in the last few years. And he's the interior minister, and he's on the FBI wanted list. And also a number of other members of the cabinet, they are on the blacklist of the United Nations. And to me, it just simply appears that Afghanistan has been handed over. And it's not just the fault of the United States, but also the Afghan leaders that have not been able to get their act together over a long period of time and really created the type of political system and participatory settings that there would not be a much gap between the state and society. I mean, you know, the Afghan leadership had become incredibly unpopular and alienated from the public. But at the same time, it is really a combination of the United States policy options that really followed in Afghanistan, you know, as well as the failures of the Afghan leaders that have handed over Afghanistan now in the governance of Afghanistan to essentially what the American Secretary of State Antony Blinken acknowledged in a congressional hearing the year before yesterday that it's a terrorist organization.
Of the four women peace negotiators, those the delegates that were appointed to the intra-Afghan negotiating team on behalf of the Afghanistan government, one of them, Fawazi Kufi, she gave a very interesting interview to Turkish television before the fall of Kabul, in fact, some time before, a couple of months before, and she spoke about the Taliban in terms of she'd been negotiating with them as part of the intra-Afghan group over 6 months. And she said some interesting things such as, you know, they've always paid shown her great respect as a woman, et cetera, et cetera. And then she said, it is like we are dealing with two Taliban, those here in Doha, part of the intra-Afghan negotiating team, and they are respectful, they are educated, and they understand women's rights, not necessarily that they agree with them, but they know them. And then she said, and then the other Taliban are the foot soldiers on the street, and they have not changed in 20 years. They have the same mentality and the same approach as the Taliban of 96 to 2001.
I think we should remember that the last time that the Taliban took over, the former president was, his mutilated body was hung from a telegraph pole and various other terrible atrocities took place. That hasn't happened this time. Okay, the president fled with a whole lot of cash, but it hasn't happened yet. They're still talking to people like Hamid Karzai, the former president. So I don't think at this point we can say that it's going to be as bad as last time. And don't forget as well that today's terrorist can be yesterday's freedom fighter. And Haqqani, the man who founded the Haqqani network, was a close friend of the United States and Britain during the Russian occupation of Afghanistan. I just make those points. On the question of the speed of the takeover, it was, you know, clearly the intelligence assets of all the major allied powers were focused on Afghanistan. And to say that they were shocked and surprised, I think is a little bit either a terrible failure or they were telling porkies. I'm not quite sure which one it is.